Hi friends, welcome to Thunders, and today what we are gonna see is an air conditioner, and this is from Sharp. The model number is AHXP13PHD, and this is not a new model from Sharp. This is an older model. It's a 2014 model, not a 2015 model. But even after that, I would still recommend this model, because after using this particular model, I'm really happy. So coming on to this particular AC, as you could see, the model number and the unit, this is the indoor unit, and there's an inverter AC, which means it does consume only very less amount of power. And this is a particular remote that is supplied along with the AC. And in this particular video, what we are going to see is the remote, the indoor unit, how it performs, the sound level of the AC, the power consumption, and as well some miscellaneous features that are available along with the AC. So at first we could take a look at the remote first. I mean, these are the buttons available, and we could switch on the AC using that, and the mode button, which gives three particular modes: auto, cool, and dry mode. And there's an eco button. You could see, as you could see, eco button is used to switch the power levels, especially like if you want to use this AC as a 1 ton or a 0.8 ton, I mean 0.75 ton AC, you could do that. And that blue color button is a plasma cluster, and it's an ion that can be released to the room that can give some kind of freshness, as the company claims. And coming on to this, this temperature level, etc., everything is there like normal AC. So we could switch on the AC. I used to use this particular AC at 26 degrees Celsius, because I'm not using it. My parents are using it. So after switching it on, the sound level will be a bit high. I mean, during the initial 2 or 3 seconds, and then later on it settles down. So I will just leave you the sound now. It will be a bit on the higher side because the camera microphone is too sensitive, I think. So it's not that loud. I would say it's from 30 dB, 30-35 dB, I think. If the AC is placed at a sufficient higher level, then I don't think it will cause any problem. And this is a vertical, I mean, there are two swing adjustments for this particular model. I mean, this is the PHD. If you're going for the PET or other model, they won't be having the swing adjustments like this. And this is the PHD model, which comes with four-way swing, and here you could adjust the horizontal swing. As you could see, that blade will move in the horizontal direction to both the sides, and you could adjust the swing, I mean the vertical and horizontal swing, by using the remote and the two buttons. And that is the vertical swing. As you could see, the vertical swing is happening now. I mean, if you would like to keep the keep it not swinging, or if you need a fixed position, just press the button once and the plate will be fixed over there. And again, if you press one more time, it will continue its normal flow. And this is a cool button. I mean, this is the auto mode, sorry. My mistake. And there are three modes, as I mentioned before. There are three modes: as auto, cool, and dry mode. I would recommend using the cool mode, because that is sufficient and it consumes much less power compared to the auto mode. And if your room is under 110 square feet or around 100 square feet, I would recommend you use the 80% eco button, because that will run the AC at 80% of the of its original consuming power. So that can save you some bucks, I think. And this is the sound level. The sound level at maximum fan speed. For normal use, I would recommend the auto mode with minimal fan speed. I mean, a fan speed of 1 is sufficient for you to use. I mean, for normal use, I'm telling. But if you wanna cool down the room in a flash, then you could use a super jet button. That is a top right hand side button. That is a super jet button with an arrow. You could use that button, and it will. In fact, it consumes a lot. Larger amount of power. Means I've used an energy meter, and the power rating will be something around 1400 to 1700 watts if you're using a superjet. And if you're using an eco mode, or if you're using a normal auto mode, the power consumption will be under 1000 watts. And if you're using a 60% mode, the power consumption will be under 800 watts. And for this particular model, I can show you, like, I've tested, like, if you're bringing, I mean, if you're using a temperature of 26, because I used to give it 26 in this AC. So if you're using 26, then the power consumption will be around 500 watts after the initial cool down. For the first, I think half an hour, it will work in around 800 watts. Then later on, it will reduce the amount of power it requires to 500 or below 500. Around 400, it will come. And if it is at night, it can go below that also. So I think efficiency wise, the AC is doing really, really good. And like as you could see, this is like that's the plasma cluster ion. I mean, that blue color light illuminates only when I'm using the plasma ion, and I don't know whether there is any difference, only some odor difference I felt, that's all, when we are using the plasma cluster ion. So as you could see, this is a timer setting. I mean, you could set the timer with an incremental limit of 30 minutes, means every you could increase the limit by 30 plus 30 plus 30 like that. So 30 minutes, 1 hour, 1:30, 2, 2:30 like that, and totally 12 hour. And that is an unfortunate problem with this AC with timer. What happens is, if the power goes, I mean, if the current or the power goes in between, the timer will be set to, I mean, it will be resetted automatically. Means once the AC comes back after a power failure or something, then there it won't remember that there was a timer. So that is one thing. I mean, it's a setback. And as what I already shown you, there is an option to turn off all the LEDs at night, and there is an option to control the airflow towards you by using a button, and this is a particular button that you could use, and the airflow will be adjusted so that the flow will be the blade will be adjusted horizontally so that the air will be going upwards instead of coming downwards, and it will fill the room. So in my point of view, this AC is a really good one. It cools down the room in 5 minutes if it is 26, and if it is set at a 20 or 22 degree, I've tried, and it will take some 20 minutes, I think 15 to 20 minutes for chilling down to 22 degree Celsius, and it's working really fine. It's cool enough, and the sound is normal. I mean, there is nothing like loud or something. So I would really recommend this particular AC model for this summer. And if you do have any questions, just ask me in the comment section. Thank you for watching.